changed.
Yeah, I just had the impulse.
Yeah, it makes you look...
I didn't do it to make me look younger.
No, I'm just more yourself.
Yeah, maybe that's it. You know, after seeing you again, I realize how much has really changed.
Well, we've both changed.
More and more, I'm wondering if that's for the better.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes I think...
What?
No.
You know, I really miss the freedom we had. I miss being able to give myself to something or to someone. I really haven't been able to do that.
I thought you had done that with Cruz.
Robert, I'm just not remembering what you said or what you did. I'm remembering the way I felt and how we were cheated of that freedom and each other.
This is a pretty sudden change of heart.
Well, sometimes it's very difficult what you ask of me. I mean, you stand over my shoulder and you want me to remember promises that I made to myself that I never knew I couldn't keep. Of dreams that I let slip away. Of things that I swore I would never become. And then I realize what I did become.
I'm sorry if I shamed you in any way by trying to make you remember the part of yourself you gave up.
No. I don't want you to think that I'm talking about Cruz, that something's wrong with my life with him. I mean, I'm talking about me.
Why is it you can never talk to me without some mention of him?
Well, it's hard for me to think about the fact that the reason he's not here with me is that you have him somewhere.
Well, I hope this all isn't just a build-up for another impassioned plea.
No. It's just that I was really angry, and I was hurt, and you told me to not think about it, and you took the pressure off, and when that happened, then I started to remember things.
What did you remember?
Well, that night on the yacht, you know, at the party, I remembered some things, and there's some pieces I can't quite fit in, and I don't want you to do it for me. It's just I thought maybe you could ask me some questions, and then it might bring it back.
Which would also bring Cruz back.
Yeah. But you know, if he was at home, and he was safe, I would still have to admit to myself that I want to know how it ended. For myself.
Look, I want to talk about this some more, but I can't right now. I'm expecting someone. Can I meet you later?
I can come back.
No, let's meet on your father's yacht.
All right.
In a couple hours' time?
I can go at the back.
No, we don't have anything to hide.
Mrs. Castillo, this is unexpected.
Excuse me.
Oh, by the way, I looked into that matter of the disappearance of your husband. We found no evidence that any of my employees or Mr. Barr were involved.
Well, that's quite all right.
Well, Robert, I always drew the line at sleeping with a woman whose husband I had killed. But I suppose these things are a matter of individual taste.
I don't like it, and I want it to stop.
You called me here for ultimatums.
Look, I didn't like the order to kill Castillo, and I don't like this kangaroo court you're using to torment Julia Capwell. Now, what is on this disc that is so important anyway?
That's not our topic. For all intents and purposes, it doesn't exist.
What do you mean you made such a fuss about it? You got everybody but my cleaning lady out trying to find it for you.
The disc contains whatever I say it does, since it's coded in a double password and the contents are coded.
Why are you going to so much trouble, then, if no one can access it?
When you housebreak a pet, it doesn't know the difference between Soiling the linoleum, which does no harm, or soiling the sofa, which does. But you've got to wrap it in the snout whenever or wherever it misbehaves to convey the general principle.
I don't suppose this would have anything to do with whatever it is you're orchestrating down in El Diablo. You see, when I run a corporation, I do it with my eyes open.
Diablo is not our topic either. Though I suppose we'll have to talk about it someday in the not too distant future. Is there anything else? Because I've got plans for this evening. I've managed to coax Sasha away from the pool at Palm Springs for a visit. I think she's getting tired of me. Maybe I'm getting tired of her. It's hard to tell.
Maybe I'm getting tired of our partnership. It's been very beneficial to both of us. I'd hate to see it be jeopardized. But your methods, the ones you're using now, are not mine. They're not particularly smart. I don't think they're going to be particularly effective.
Everything I've done to protect you, Robert. Would you prefer to be back in the San Sebastian prison?
I can protect myself.
Well, you're not doing a very convincing job of it. You were the pride of my stable, Robert. You were a thoroughbred in the wild when I found you. Now that I've fed you and groomed you and tamed you, you want to run wild again. Too bad. I'll tell Sasha you send your best regards.
Sure you'd be here.
Neither was I.
Are we alone?
Yes.
Okay. You know, it starts the same way. I love you, Eden.
How do we go back? Go back. This isn't why we came here.
Isn't it?
I wanted to tell you everything I was remembering.
I think there's more than that.
What else?
Can you honestly tell me you don't feel anything for me?
No.
If you had never met Cruz, I think we would have had a chance again.
I don't know. Yeah. Maybe we would have.
Thank you for that.
You know, you ask too much. Whenever I tell the truth, I feel like I'm not being truthful with somebody.
You don't have to say anything to Cruz about what you say to me tonight.
I can't live like that.
You used to be able to. You used to be able to live more than one life at a time. I know the life that you have now has made you very happy, but don't you ever wonder?
Doesn't everybody?
Yeah, but when most people look back at what they gave up along the way, they can see that they gave it up by choice, whether they knew it at the time or not. We didn't give anything up. It was taken from us. It was stolen.
All right. I loved you. Because you love things about me that nobody else did. I mean, I was very difficult. And that's what made it very hard with Cruz, is because I was reckless and I was moody. I mean, lying was like breathing, but then there came a time in my life when I wasn't happy and I realized I had to change. I mean, it was a choice, and I admired Cruz. So I took on his values. I mean, I don't think that's so wrong, do you? I don't think it's hypocritical to want to be better. But I do wonder what it's like to be loved just the way you are. I think that's why I wonder what happened to us. Maybe it was me.
No, it wasn't you.
All right. Maybe we should just go over what happened on the yacht that night.
Okay.
You came to find me and kiss me. Raul was there and you were angry at him. And I was frightened and you were trying to hurt him like you did anybody who looked at me or touched me strange. That's where we stopped, right?
You didn't want to go any further.
When I got home, I started thinking about Raul and me.
Go on.
He wanted something.
Yes.
He didn't want me with you.
Because of what?
Because I don't know. There was somebody else.
Who?
I don't know. Why would there be somebody else?
Why not? There was a party going on. Come on.
Because I thought I saw a face, but I don't know.
Well, I guess you're not ready yet.
No, I am. Robert, just tell me some of the people that were there that night. Just tell me somebody.
I can't.
Please, don't say that.
I can't because I don't know. Haven't you figured that out yet? I don't know all of it.
Well, then this is really pointless, isn't it?
What was the point to begin with? I'm confused. I thought you said nobody knew you were here.
No.
Hello. Sounds like your mother.
Mama? Yes? Why? Oh, my God. Yes, I'm coming home right now. I'm sorry. There's been an accident. I have to go.
I'm not in love, so don't forget it. It's just a silly phase I'm going through. And just because I call you up, don't get me wrong, don't think you've got it made. I'm not in love, no, no.
Raul, come on, get up.